While frontline workers lined up for their vaccines, Catholics all over the world lined up for their ashes. This year, the Ash Wednesday ritual had to be adjusted to follow the COVID-19 regulations. Mahalia Joseph Wharton has more.
Usually, ashes would be applied by hand, but due to the pandemic, ashes were applied with cotton swabs. The Vatican also recommended that priests sprinkle ashes on people's heads to avoid contact. When TTT News visited Our Lady of Perpetual Help in San Fernando on Wednesday, they opted to use the cotton swab method to apply the ashes on parishioners. Ash Wednesday marks the beginning of Lent. According to the Roman Catholic Archbishop of Port of Spain, Charles Jason Gordon, the method chosen to administer the ashes to the faithful came as a result of a small study done by the Archdiocese.
We did a little focus group very quickly when we got the instructions from Rome, and we knew that that was a no-sell in Trinidad and Tobago, because when people spend a whole pile of money on the weave,
that, oh, the extensions.
And the extensions, the Remy. They say you can't put that in my head because that can't wash. So you know we
call it dry weather here.
So you know that was a no go. Right. Italy could do that.
Right.
In the absence of Carnival 2021, Archbishop Gordon answered the question on several people's lips. How come there's Lent if there was no carnival?
You know, if we're going to say goodbye to the flesh, let's do a little festivity before we do that. And that's how the carnival came about.
Mm-hmm.
So the carnival actually is the add-on to the Lenten period.
Right.
And not the opposite way around.
Right.
And so the whole idea of the carnival is have this festivity. Ash Wednesday, we go into deep sobriety,
mm-hmm.
and we have these 40 days of sobriety where we think and live very differently. So okay. The contrast between the two is what creates.
Ash Wednesday marks the start of the Lenten period leading up to Easter. The ashes symbolizes both death and repentance. Mahalia Joseph Wharton, TTT News.